This is Mr. Travis 779. I'm not sure if you guys can see this or not. The light in this room is not the world's greatest, but I'll try my best. Just wanted to give you a little bit more history on my old Bronco and the reason why I bought it for the price I paid for it was this. The previous owner, which kept it for many years, kept extensive service records on this Bronco. I've got four envelopes full of service records, dating back all the way until the early 90s. I've gone through most of it, but I mean, a prime example, this was done back in 01, and the guy did the thermostat, a water pump, transmissions, fluid service, drilled and tapped a broken bolt, I don't know why, you know, gasket, water pump, you know, it extensive service records were kept, and this is just one folder full. I have extensive records going back. I mean, the guy looks like he had a water pump bolt that broke, they had to re-tap, they use ATF dextron for the transmission. So it goes back to many, many years of extensive service records. I mean, I've got everything here that I could ever know about this vehicle. This was back in 2000. You know, again, spark plugs haven't changed, oil filter, looked like belt and alternator was changed. In ignition cable set, fuel injector motor, HVAC service. Fuel injector injection motor, VAC service. I don't know what that is, but you know, there is fuel injection motor. That must be the, interesting. I mean, there is extensive service. Fuel injector chemical cleaner, a belt was changed. Total price of $544. Extensive emissions servicing. And it just goes back to earlier and earlier. I mean, the previous owner kept extensive service records. See, this is an invoice. See if I can show you guys. This is an invoice for 2001. Again, this was done in early 2000. You know, it looks like it had an ignition switch problem and an ignition switch and been with an alternator accumulator or something. But I mean, anyways, you know, they got extensive service records. Checked for dieseling while driving, no start. Ran fuel and ignition check, found no power to ignition system. Further checking, found ignition switch assembly failed. Pulled failed assembly and installed new, adjust and tighten shift linkage. Loosened for tow to shop. Recheck starting problem, found no further problems at this time. So you know, there was extensive service records done. You know, hose clamp, engine coolant. No, it just goes on and on and on of different services that were done on this over its years. Everything, you know, reman driveline rear. So they change, they must have had a U-joint or something fail or something with the driveline. You know, battery hold down kit, which actually didn't work very well, but Bosch remanufactured starter. So someone over here, looks like this was done back in 01. So it looks like a lot of this stuff was done back in 01, 2000, 2001. You know, more in emissions inspections. And according to this, it all passed. Emissions inspection. Here's a bill of sale from when he bought the vehicle. I guess it looks like he paid a monthly payment. So there is extensive history. Here's all the service for the stereo system, which he had installed, which is the $500 stereo system. And no, here was a Les Schwab brake service, I believe, was done on this. Front bearings, front axle, calipers. Like, it's got remanufactured calipers. 303 total. So, you know, there is extensive stuff done on this Bronco that I found. You know, that in all reality, you know, there's a lot of stuff that was done that was kept up. This Bronco was kept up. I mean, the transmission is original, and you know, it shifts fine. You know, but the transmission fluid was never allowed to get old. Was never allowed to show signs of age. It was always changed. I mean, that's why I bought the vehicle, was because of the extensive service history and records. You just don't see this very often on this old of a vehicle. These older vehicles, I mean, most people just, you know, they either do it themselves, which is a lot of what I have. Excuse me, guys. I'm sorry, I'm just putting this stuff away. I can get out the other one. No, there's just a lot of extensive history on this. And this is another envelope that I have that has extensive history on it. If I can get it out without. Now, again, looks like front brakes were done, remanufactured brakes. Looks like this was done in 2000. This is pretty old. This might not have had a brake job done in a long time. Yeah, it was done back in 2000. The Les Schwab guarantee. What else do we have here? Here's a Carfax history report. Of course, I don't know what this dates back to. 2002. If I remember correctly, this might have been free at that time in 2002. I don't know. Anyways, it dates back then. Again, an emissions test pass. This was a Montana vehicle, is where this was at, which makes sense because it actually had an engine block heater on it. Of course, we removed it because it wasn't needed here in this state, but it wouldn't make sense why it would have an engine block heater. Let's see, this is from 2000. Looks like, again, fuel filter was changed, spark plugs was changed, alternator and belt. Some of these are duplicates, but I mean, there's a lot of paperwork here that is just random stuff that they've done over the years. Anyways, I thought it was interesting. I thought, you know, you just don't see stuff like this in vehicles as cheap as this one was. You know, granted, I've put a lot of money into it because it did sit for a while. According to documentation, the last time... this back in here. Sorry, guys, I do apologize. The last time this was really serviced was back in 2010. It's the last time this was serviced. And then after that, it stopped. The last paperwork I saw was service records dating back to 2010. And then I think after 2010, it sat for about 3 years. About 2 to 3 years. I got it in 2013, in the beginning of 2014. So, I mean, it sat for a long time, and as the history goes, it was, you know, the guy I bought it from was his son, and, you know, his dad died unexpectedly, and, He just kind of let it sit underneath the tree, and it was his dad's vehicle, and he didn't want to touch it for a long time, and it was kind of a sad story, but it's kind of a sad ending. So, and then after that, it kind of just went to history, and one day he decided to sell it, and I saw it on Craigslist for... Guy wanted originally like $3,500. I wasn't going to pay that for it. That was too much money. The vehicle was overheating when I was driving it, and the oil was really bad. But it ran. It did run. So I figured, okay, I'll give him, you know, $800 for it. I'll take a chance on it. After seeing all this history and seeing the bushings, the tires were brand new. Everything had been done on it. So I figured, okay, let's tow it home and see what happens. And sure enough, in the end, I don't regret it. I think it was a good buy. It needed a little bit more than what I thought it did. You know, when it started leaking the oil, I don't touch transmissions. I'm not a transmission guy. They actually make me nervous when I touch them. So I had to have the oil leak. I had to have the rear main seal pulled, and they had to have it ended up being a $1,500 job, which, you know, it's kind of like, oh well, type of thing. That's the only thing in this Bronco that I've had paid that I've had to do. All the other service work I've done myself, and unfortunately I'm probably going to have to pay someone to finish it up, because I don't have the time, and I don't have the scan tools to finish it up. There's still a glitch in the system where it's given that funky idle. Oh, I need to figure that out. But anyways, this is Mr. Travis 779.